السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. Today I will take you back nearly 45 years ago when I was mad about watching الأهلي سبورتس كلاب matches, football matches. When we were in حلمية in the 60s and the 50s, before we bought our television in 1960-61, I used to go and watch Al-Ahli and Zamalek matches in different houses to watch it on the television. And I remember one of the top matches between the two teams when Ahli introduced three young subs to lead the game, and they won 3-0 against Zamalek. This was my upbringing. It was my brother, very mad about Al-Ahli at that time. When I grew up and they became in the medical school, I used to take my nephew with me, Ahmed, to go to watch these matches. And then eventually Ahmed started to make all his flat or Czech family as an Ahli supporter. It was one day in 75, I think, and when Al-Ahli was playing with another team in the north called Al-Masri football team. Al-Masri football team got very, very zealous, hot-headed spectators. And at the time, Port Said was made as a free zone. And we had a friend of us, a colleague of me, Dr. Said Ghizi, who became later on a cardiologist working in the cardiology hospital center in Mbaba in Cairo. We went to his flat in Port Said, bought some of these items from the free zone. Then the following day, we went to see the match. We were the only four people inside the stadium who are actually supporting an Ahli football team who came from Cairo to Port Said in the north. And the first half went smoothly. No problem. The second half, I think after 15 or 20 minutes, Al-Ahli scored a goal. Our reaction was a spontaneous reaction of joy. The four of us stood up to hail and yell, and we looked around us. Everybody was looking at us. I said, oh my God, we're going to be dead today, because we know that the spectators or the supporter of Al-Masri football team actually how they react with their guests. And we acted, all of us, the four of us, oh my God, to change our feeling from the joy into the sorrow. We put our hands on the top of our head and start screaming, oh my God, 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 why? Start to act. I don't think the people trusted us or believed us, but at least we sat down quiet, counting our breathing times and time and the time to end the to see the end of the football match. And even a little bit scared when we're going out among the spectators and the supporters, somebody might actually point at us so they can kick us or actually do something bad to us. Here my message is to the young people. 22 individuals kicking one ball. Okay, I can enjoy myself, but why should I become stressful? Why should I lose? Why should I fight? Why should I kick? Why should I argue? And I remember some people died during this match when Egypt was playing against, I think, Paraguay in the World Cup in Russia 2 years ago. He had a stroke and hemorrhage in the brain. In the good old days, I used to watch Al-Ahli, then I watch local teams here in UK, then I used to support the Egyptian national team, and sometimes the World Cup was my team. And I was finding myself under heavy stress, and if my team lose the match, I stay a day or two or three upset. What? Why should I be upset? The fame and the name goes to Mo Salah, goes to Sadio Mane, goes to Messi, goes to Cristiano Ronaldo, goes to Barcelona, and Inter Milan, others, but not for me. So please, my advice to you young men and young women, please enjoy the sport, but don't overstress yourself and start arguing and fighting with your colleague. It's not worth it. Please, it's not worth it. Do something good for your community, good for your society, and good for yourself. Be objectively positive. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.